स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई प्रोफेसर प्रशांत बुआ, डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस जूनागढ़। सो वी आर ऑन अ लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ डिजाइन रेनफोर्स कॉन्क्रीट स्ट्रक्चर 7 सेम सिविल। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड अ न्यू सम ऑफ सेस्मिक कोएफिशिएंट मेथड विच हैज 5 स्टोरी ऑफ बिल्डिंग हैज साइज 30 by 30 meter एंड इट इज लोकेटेड ऑन भुज ऑन हार्ड सॉइल। The floor-wise lump mass are given 2000, 2500, 2500, 2500 and last one is 2001. For the same data, we already calculate up to the VB. So, last step, previous lectures, our last step of today's example is remain pending. So, today we will shall complete this example and later on we have to start center of mass and calculate the center of stiffness, which was very important parameter while you calculating the earthquake resistance building. So I quick revise about the previous lectures and then we started or completed this sum. So we are given the 5 story have lump mass is given, already height is given. So we found total seismic weight of building capital W and height. So our next step is calculating the fundamental natural time period TA. So we know the equation of TA is given on clause number 7.6.1. So using this code we have calculated the TA and value of TA is given 0.304 seconds. After the calculating the TA, we start the calculation of design seismic base shear is denoted by VB, and VB is calculated on clause number 7.5.3. VB is equal to AH into W. So W we already calculate total seismic weight of building. Right now the unknown property is AH, the coefficient of seismic base shear, and AH is equal to Z by 2 multiply by I by R multiply by SA by G. So as per the given data in our example, due to properties of types of zone, hard soil, according to table 2 we have to decide Z value is 0.36 and it's the school building, so importance factors I is equal to 1 and response reduction factor. So we have to consider seismic special moment resisting frames and that's why the R is getting 5. After the finding out the all your value SA by G, I, R and Z, we have to calculate AH, and AH we have to found 0.09. After calculating the AH, we have calculating the VB, AH into W. So VB we have to find out 1044 kilonewton. So next our last step is remaining for this example is nothing but last step is vertical distribution of base shear. So already we calculate the total base shear. Now we have to distribute it in floor wise and finding out the base shear of individual story and finding out V is nothing but shear force. So the design of base shear, compute above the distribution along the height and the building as per the clause number 7.7, page number 24 in IS 1893. So our VB we already calculate 1044 kilonewton. So we make one table to calculating the base shear. For that, first I would add in first column floor level. So different floor level is given. In our case floor height is same. Then WI, we already calculate WI is given directly in our data. Then HI, height of floor. Then WI, HI square is given in the third column. Then next WI, HI square divided by summation of WI, HI square. This is our next column. After that, finding out QI. QI is nothing but VB into WI, HI square divided by summation of WI HI square, and last one is our shear force VI. So these are our basic term. W is given in kilonewton, height we have to find out in meter, again Qi is kilonewton, and finally shear force is getting kilonewton. So we have given 5 different floor at a different height of different lump mass. So starting with the top story, it means story number 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Likewise we have to calculate distributing the base shear. So we know that at the story number 5, what should be the our Wi? 2100 kilonewton. Then story number 4, 2500. Story number 3, same 2500. Story number 2, same 2500. And story 1, it's given 2000. So likewise, already the seismic weight of different floor is given in our data. According to height is also given. So first story total building height is given 18.5 minus 3, it means 15, because every floor wise height is given 3.5. So 18.5 minus 3.5 15, 15 minus 3.5 11.5, 11.5 minus 3.5 it means 8, and 8 minus 3.5 4.5. It means our first story is rest ground to 4.5, the next story is 8 meter, 11.5, 15, and total height of building 18.5. So we have Wi, we have already Hi, so just multiply by Wi into Hi square, it means 2100 multiply by 18.5 square. So value you have to give, after the calculation value you have to found 718725. Same way, the next value is given 562500. Then next 330625. Next value you have to found 160000. And last one is 4050. After the calculating all value, we have to get the summation of all 5 loads. So we have to getting summation of Wi Hi square, and you have to found 1812350. So what is our next step? Our next column is Wi into summation of Wi square. So you have to take one by one Wi Hi square answer and divide by our total summation of Wi Hi square is nothing but 1812350. So you have to find out value 0.3966, 0.3104, 0.1824, 0.0883, 0.0223. So this 5 value you have to found. Now what is our next step? We already calculate Wi Hi square divided by summation of Wi Hi square. So just this column is multiplied by only value of Vb. Now what should be the value of Vb? 1044. So this value is multiplied by just 1044. It means Vb multiplied by 12345, column number 5. So you have to directly calculate Qi. So 1044 multiplied by 0.396. So we have to found 41405. Now 1044 multiplied by 0.314, we have to calculate 324.60. Likewise, the next floor you have to calculate 190.43, then 92.13 and 23.28. I given one cross check in our previous example. When you have to calculating the web Qi means distribution of base shear, after the completion this step you have to get the summation. The summation should be must be equal to the value of Vb, then your distribution vertical is okay. Otherwise you have to done some mistake in that calculating all multiplication with Wi Hi. So if you have to summation this all 5 Qi, you are getting the value of equal to Vb. Now we have to distribute this vertical direction and finding out the base shear. So in that we have to started with 1044. It should be like in first floor 1044 minus 23.28 individual story QI of 1. You have to calculate in total VB. So you have to getting second story 1020.72. 1020.72 minus 92.13. So you have to getting 928.54. 928.54 minus 1019.43. So you have to calculate 738.11. 738.11 minus 3240. So you have to found 1410.4. Again here the cross check is this both value are getting same. Then your distribution is done perfectly. So there are the two check while we have to calculating the table of seismic coefficient method in that base shear. Your summation of total QI is equal to VB and after getting the distribution in floor Y, your last floor is getting the value of same as a QI. So there are the two check while we have to use seismic coefficient diagram. So our last step is to draw the lateral load diagram and shear diagram. So likewise we have to draw the lateral load diagram and shear diagram. So we know that we have a five story in that this is 5 4 3 2 and 1 and this is ground story. So at a 5 we have to find out lateral load 414.04. At story 4 we have to calculate 324.06. You have to check in our previous table third value 192.43, then next value is 192.18 and first story we have to calculate 23.28. So we have to add this all the graph. We have to find out lateral load diagram. This is so how the lateral load diagram affect on our different story. And last one is our important is shear diagram. So now we draw the shear diagram. So same we have to divide in a 5 story 5 4 3 2 and 1. So in 5 story we have to get VB 4144.4 same like QI of first story. Then it should be constant while the second floor is not occur. So in 4 meter we have to find out 738.11. It should be constant up to story 3. Then it should be increase. How much increase? 928.54. It should be constant at story 2. Then it should be increase 1020.72. And then it should be constant in one story. Then it should be increase 1044. It's nothing but our total VB. So this is our shear diagram. So likewise we have to draw the shear force diagram for particular this example. So this is our last step of the previous example, distribution of base shear and draw the lateral load diagram and shear force diagram. I think you have to clear the doubt about all the method of seismic coefficient method is very important. Due to this method we finding out the base shear of different story wise and then after later on the calculating the base shear we can distribute it in floor wise. So this is very useful method to finding out the lateral load and as well as the distribution as per the earthquake load is occur. So now we move forward the further example on the different types of earthquake resistance building is nothing our module 5. So we directly go with the how to calculate center of mass and center of stiffness. So these both are a very important term to finding out the center of mass and center of stiffness, while particularly our building layout are non-uniform. At that time it's very important to finding out the this center of mass and center of stiffness. So for that we have to start one example to finding out the center of mass and center of stiffness. So we know that what is center of mass. Center of mass is the point through which resultant of masses of any system act in known as center of mass. So at center of mass we know the distance of center of mass throughout the building is located. So this point corresponding to the center of gravity of mass of system. And what should be the center of stiffness? So the point through which resultant of restoring force of a system is act. This is center of stiffness. Another word you have to call center of rigidity. So both are in difference, center of mass and center of stiffness. Center of mass, where it should be located the total mass of building, and center of stiffness, it should be located total the resultant of restoring force. So these both are different phenomena. While the earthquake is occurring in horizontal direction, at that time these both phenomena are very important to knowing the building, where building is non-uniform distribution. So start with the first example is nothing but finding out the center of mass. So in this example we find out the center of mass. So this example is based on center of mass. So please read carefully data and see the figure. According to figure we have to find out the center of mass for particular this figure. So locate the center of mass for a building having non-uniform distribution of mass as shown in figure. So you can see that figure. One figure has a rectangle ABCD. In that different mass are located particular building. Suppose one portion of building has getting 1400 kg per meter cube mass, second element is 1200 kg per meter square, and remaining portion is 1000 kg per meter square. So there are the different non-uniform mass and a particular building. So we cannot easily to find out the center of mass because it's not in center of building. It should be varies from center because all the elements have different mass and it's not to be uniform. So that's why at a particular non-uniform distribution of mass this method is helpful to finding out the center of mass. So what should be the done in our first step? So given figure we have to convert in a different parts and finding out that center of mass. For that consider, please write down, this is the important note. Consider lower left corner, it means in our case A, as the origin. We already consider in any of example origin have to consider lower left corner of any building. So in our case what should be the lower left corner? This is left corner and this is the lower, it means last joint of given particular any building, or you can say the figure. So let us divide a roof slab into the four rectangular part as shown in figure. So now we divide it into four rectangle part, so we can easily find out individual all four part. So what can be done? So same figure I will be draw in repeated and convert it into the four rectangle part. So likewise figure is given, there is the part 1 getting 1400 kg per meter cube load is given, Second part, load is given 1200 kg per meter cube. Again, I converted this remaining three part. This is third one. The load is given 1000 kg per meter cube. And this whole remaining portion are same, but I have distributed in four rectangles. So it should be a same like part three. So now in whole figure, I converted into the four part. Part one as a rectangle. What should be the size of part one? The 6 meter is given. And this one is 10 meter. So our first part is 10 by 6. Our second part is, this remaining is 20. You can see that in our original figure, this is also 20. 20 by 4. This distance is given by 4 meter. So our second part is 20 by 4. Our third part, so this is same as 20. And this distance total is given 14. You can see 40 minus 6. So you have to find out the 8 meter for remaining. So third part is 20 by 8 and this one is 10 by 8. So this is our remaining distance, 14 minus 6. So is nothing but 8 meter. So likewise, we have to simply distribution in different rectangular parts. Now individually we have to calculating the difference mass of the particular rectangle shape. For suppose mass of part 1. So what is the mass of part 1? Is nothing but 1400 kg per meter cube. Meter square. Mass of part 2. Mass of part 2 is 1200 kg per meter square. Mass of part 3 is 1000 kg per meter square. And mass of part 4 is 1000 per kg per meter square. So now I converted a whole building in four different rectangular, part 1, part 2, part 3 and part 4. And for that individual mass is given as per the data. So now we calculate the center of mass in x direction and center of mass in y direction. Because in both the direction the mass is non-uniform. It means it not uniform. Either it should be x or it should be y. So that's why we find out center of mass in x direction and center of mass in y direction. So what is our next step? We finding out the, let consider xm and ym be the coordinates of center of mass. So first we have to calculate xm. What is calculate center of mass in x? So what is our origin? As I say in earlier, our origin is left lower corner. It means A. So what is the xm equation? Generally I discuss. So xm is equal to summation of mi xi divided by summation of m1. So what will we done while calculating the xm? So we have to calculate different mi, means area of particular part, multiply by x distance and divide by summation of m. So right now in this figure we have four area. So likewise we have to calculate. So first taking first area, what should be the first area? Is 10 by 6. First area you can see over there is nothing but 10 by 6. So our mi is 10 by 6 and what is xi? So mass is given 1400. So xi is a 10 by 6 area of particular mass, and for that mass is given 1400. So this is our mi, load into this particular area, multiply by x. So what should be the x? This is mi. small mi. Load into area. It's give the mass for particular part and now remaining in x. So how we can find out x? So particular this is 10 meter span. This is 10. So what should be the half distance is getting x. So 10 by 2 x is equal to 5. So here I multiply by with 5. Next area. What should be the second area? 10 by 8. Next is 10 by 8. Mass is 1000. So this is our fourth area. 10 by 8. Mass is 1000. Again x is equal to 5. That's why I'll take first, because both the x is difference. That's why first we take part 1 and then take part 2. Now remaining is part 3, part 2, 20 by 8. Our part 2 is 20 by 8. 20, this one, 20 by 8. And what should be the x? You can 20 by 8 multiply by 1000. That should be the mass of particular that portion. Now x is important. So here you have to see that we have to take origin at A. So for A to this part, this is 10 meter. From this is A. So 20, 20 to half, 10, 10 plus 10, because we have to take origin as A. So 10 plus 10, 20. So this portion has x is 20. So I put the value of x is equal to 20. So this is our third portion. The next portion is again 20 by 4, this one, 20 by 4, and the load particular of that part is 1200. Again x is 20. So this is part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4. This is mi multiply by xi, divide by mi. So what should be the mi? 10 into 6 divide by 1000, 1400, plus 10 into 8 multiply by 1000, plus 20 into 8 multiply by 1000, and plus 20 into 4 multiply by 1200. So if you have to solve this equation, you have to find out xn, and value you have to find out. This total value 674000 divide by 460000. So you have to calculate yourself. This is our total first term answer. This is divide by total mi answer. So you have to find out xn, 4.652 meter. So now our first step is completed to find out xm. Similarly, we find out ym. So what is the equation of ym? Same way, summation of mi into iy divided by summation of mi. So this value is same, 4600, because summation of mi in y direction it's not be changed. What should be the variable y1? M1 is the same mi, 10 into 6 by 1400, 10 into 8 by 1000, 20 into 8 by 1000, and 20 into 4 by 1200. So this is the fix. Only the yi is changed. In previous we have to take xi, in now we have to check iy. So now I calculating the ym. So for that, ym is equal to first part, 10 into 6 multiply by 1400. This is first part multiply by y1. So how we calculate y1? Again you have to see that figure, our previous figure that we have to convert it into the fourth part. Now we calculate about y1. So y1 is also calculated as the origin of A. So you have to take this. This is the 8. So up to first part, 6 by 2, this is our y, 6 by 2, so is 3, 3 plus 8, 11. So what should be the y1? 11. Then next, 10 by 8 multiply by 1000. You can see this part. So what should be the y1? 8 by 2, 4. 8 by 2, 4. Third part, this one. 20 by 8. What should be the y1? Again, it should be getting 5. Because this one is 6. 6 minus 4, 2. So 8 plus 2. What should be the height? This is the height of 10 meter. So 10 by 2 is getting 5. So what should be the third portion? 20 by 10. The load is 1000 and y1 is 5. Again I repeat, y 51, because this is the offset, 2 meter is offset given in on that particular shape. Now we calculate third step. So it should be 20 meter wide and 10 meter in y direction. So 10 by 2 is getting 5. So remaining our portion is this portion, 20 by 4. And what should be the y? 10 plus 4 by 2. It means 2, 10 plus 2 is total 12. So next is 20 by 4 multiply by 1200 and multiply by 12. This is our total yi into mi into yi, and in divide by the same value for find out in previous exam. It should be same. So after the calculating in first term, you have to getting answer 3396 00 divided by 460000. So after calculating, you have to find out 7.383. So this is our ym. So likewise, we have to calculating xm and ym. So you can see that if the building is uniform, so what should be the y? So total height is given 10 plus 4, 14. So 14 by 2, 7 is our y if our mass is uniform. But in this case, mass is not uniform. So what should be the y? Is getting 7.385. Same way, if mass is uniform, then what should be the x? 20 plus 10, 30, 30 by 2, 15 meter. But mass is undistribution, then what should be the xm? Xm we have to calculating 14.652. So if previous figure is considered, so our x is getting something like that, 14.8, and y is getting over that. So this is our center of mass of located throughout this particular shape of building. So likewise, we have to calculating the center of mass. In previous next lecture, we again practice the center of mass and center of stiffness. Thank you students. If still have any doubt, then write in my comment box in my YouTube channels. Thank you very much for watching this video.